Okay, so today we're going to be working with JSON in JavaScript. JSON stands for JavaScript Object Notation. And you're going to be seeing, once we're going to be writing this JSON file, that it's going to be very similar to JavaScript objects. Let me make a quick JSON file, hit yes. And we have a JSON file, app file. And the first thing we want to do is to open the object. Then let's put a value in here. So we do very similar to a JavaScript object, but we put it in quotes. And I'm going to be having another one right there. And now I'm going to be making an array. And an array does not get in quotes. So you can see that it is not in quotes. And I also put straight objects in here, and they are not in quotes either. And numbers are not. So it's pretty much just strings and then the key. So the key for all of this is in quotes. And also string values. Okay, so let's hit save. And in our JavaScript file, the first thing we want to do is to require fs, because we're going to be working with the file system to save this configuration once we've been modifying it. The next thing is that we are going to be requiring the configuration that will automatically parse it and turn it into a JavaScript object. The next thing is that we're just going to be showing the configuration file. After that, we're going to be modifying it. So we're going to be doing configuration API key and setting it to a new value. You can see that the API key is currently this, and we're going to be changing it to this. After that, we want to save the configuration. We're going to be using fs write file. We're going to be writing to this configuration file, and we're going to be stringifying it, and then we're going to be checking if there's an error. We're going to throw it, else we're going to print this out safe. Also, remember when you're loading these using require, you have to do dot backslash and then the path. So if it was in a folder or if it was just straight in the same directory as your application. Okay, so let's run this. So I'm going to be doing node.app to run this. And you can see that we printed out the configuration file. And you can see that we did this here. And then also we saved it. And you can see when we go in here, it is formatically differently, but you can also see that the API key did change, and we just format this. You can see that the API key changed from the old value to the new value. So that was pretty much it. Working with JSON in JavaScript is very simple. There's not too much to it. So hopefully see you in the next one, and bye.